Now, Roche says its profits and sales will rise this year, helped by new products such as a breast cancer drug. Joining us now from Tel Aviv to discuss the pharmaceutical industry is Ori Hershovitzi, a fund manager who invests in drug stocks at Sphera Funds Management. Thank you so much, Ori, for being with us. Is this a good time to invest in pharma stocks? It seems that all the headwinds that we were concerned about, austerity measures, cutting government spendings on pharmaceuticals, didn't really quite pan out as aggressively as we thought it could.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I think the answer is definitely yes. If we look at what's happening in the industry in the last couple of years, we've seen a de-risking of the model. Hence, we've seen companies that were concentrated solely on the U.S. market with little operation in Europe and Japan, expanding their operation to emerging markets where you have companies now very well built, where they have about a third of their profits coming from the States, a third of their profits coming from Japan and the EU, and a third from emerging markets that are growing at 15 to 20% a year. So definitely a very healthy situation to be in terms of risk reward, as these stocks are generally traded around 12 times, 11 times next year's profits. They have literally no debt and they're handing out dividends of about 4%. So in my mind, very attractive, and it's still not too late to jump in.
One of the things that could thwart continuing multiple expansion might be some M&A, and the industry kind of has a long track record with M&A. Some of it successful, some of it not successful. Can you specifically talk to me about Roche, heavily focused on oncology, the sort of the genomics, the mapping story very strong, and they've talked about M&A in that space before. What happens next for Roche on the M&A front?
So very interesting question, and it all comes down to what Roche is planning in terms of strategy. It's very heavily concentrated on oncology, and the question is, do they dare out to try and do a couple of big M&A deals outside of oncology? I think they know they have to. They cannot stay a niche player in oncology, as big as this sector is, but they're selling what everybody else is saying. They want bolt-on acquisition. That means acquisition of about $5 billion, and I think we'll see at least 10 to 20 of these M&A moves this year. We have seen heavy activity in this sector last year. In my mind, the big question is, do they continue their focus on oncology or do they venture out? Something that they will have to do somewhere along the road. I'm not sure they have the mental acceptance to do it now.
Ori, were you disappointed with the dividends increase by Roche? They increased it by 8%. Were you expecting more, and does it change your view of the company?
No, not really. I think 4.1% dividend yield on the stock price is very, very nice. I think that if you look across the sector, dividend yield tends to move between 3.5 to 5%. So I think they're kind of right in the middle there. They have still about 10 billion Swiss franc in debt, which is about half times their EBITDA, so nothing to worry about. I think that you will see a lot of money being returned to the shareholders. It could be buybacks, it could be accretive M&A deals, and it could be somewhere along the line they'll decide to hike dividends again. I wouldn't put it out of the realm of possibilities.
Ori, any concerns about who will replace Stanley Fischer? What's the feeling amongst the investment community?
Yeah, very good and tough question. So I think you have to see the political landscape in Israel. What happened was that Yair Lapid, which made his view known against the way that Stanley Fischer kind of kept interest rate low, and that led to a 75% increase in real estate prices in 2007 until today. And I think Stanley Fischer sees what's coming. There's going to be a lot of pressure on Stanley Fischer to do steps that will cause real estate prices to go down, and the effect of it will be hurting the banks. I think Stanley Fischer is not one to sign on a decree like this, and I think he's from his point of view, he's doing the right thing, so he's going out. I think you'll see someone else comes in that is willing to make a big stand against real estate prices, which is the thing that dominated the last elections. And I've heard that one of the nominees is Trachtenberg. Trachtenberg is a professor that led the inquiry as to why the real estate price has gone up by 75%, and he came in with some very strong conclusion. So if he takes the helm, you can expect some massive, massive steps to take the real estate prices down. It's going to be an earthquake in the Israeli economic environment.
All right, very interesting analysis. Ori, thank you so much.